Sometimes it's good to be a little patient, right? It was like Marquez Pacquiao. When Marquez jumped in on Pacquiao,
it's easy to say shit on the outside, but
yeah,
AJ had been losing. He had been losing the majority of the five and drop. So I'm sure when he hurt him, he's like, oh, here it is. I got a chance, you know? So,
he did rock him.
He did. He hurt him.
Bam, if you were heavyweight, how would you do with the big guys?
I don't know. My style would be different.
Why? Not necessarily. Muhammad Ali had a different style than Mike Tyson, was a different style than anybody else.
If I were a heavyweight, I wouldn't be able to move the way I do.
What's the name? George Foreman? Hey. How would Bam do as a heavyweight? Same skill set.
I'd be similar to Usyk, no?
Yeah? Southpaw, right?
Yeah. It's different. The higher up you go, you're a little slower. You got staring your punches a little bit more. It's different. The heavyweight fight at a different rhythm. It's
You saw how many fans were there?
Where?
98,000.
Crazy.
If Bam fights in England, it's going to be big, Bam. I think one of your fights should be out there. Have you fought there yet?
No. I think if he would have fought in England, it would have been Sonny Edwards. I think by now, I don't think there's anybody else.
No.
I don't think there's anybody else that you can say, maybe that guy.
Hey, you broke Sonny Edwards. He hasn't talked shit since.
I still talking shit.
Not like he used to. He used to be way more.
He's fighting. Who's he fighting? Yafai. Yafai, yeah, that was gonna be good.
That's a very tough fight for him. Hey, what did he say?
He's fighting one of the Yafai brothers.
Who?
Sonny Edwards. Well, that's gonna be a better fight.
What did
Sonny
Edwards say? Your trainer's not here. He sent the B team. Who was that? Was that you?
Yeah, that's fucked up. Yeah, but that's he said be careful.
He told me I'm gonna ban you.
But then at the end, he was fucking great, dude, right? You can't fucking like that kid. I hope he wins that one.
It's a very hard fight.
Yeah, and I know the other kid. Gold medalist or something like that.
Yes.
Was he gold medalist?
Yeah. I think, yeah. He's a family from, yeah.
Something, but he's a good fighter.
Someone said Sonny looks like a mole. I don't think so. I've seen moles. They're blind. They don't have eyes. Yeah, because they live on the ground. By the way, Chop won. Did you see the highlight?
I saw the highlight.
He cooked him with like 8 punches while the guy was folding like a folding chair.
I saw the highlight.
How was the atmosphere in Mexico?
Beautiful. Yeah.
Later.
Mexico is beautiful, LA.
Mexico City, right?
Mexico City is beautiful.
Hey, they want predictions. Devin Haney versus Pita.
Yeah, Pita. I'll get my ass kicked.
Hey, Eddie Hearn went nose to nose with Devin. I gotta ask Eddie, what did you tell him? Eddie checked him. He asked him for tickets for the fight at 6 a.m.
That's how it is though. Eddie, what did Eddie say? He's like, I'm gonna give you tickets, you're not my fighter. Business.
Yeah.
It's a business for the promoters, it's gotta be a business for the fighters, it's gotta be a business for everybody.
That's true, no, it's a business.
I think they should, if they, like my dad said, if they had the tickets, they should have given to him, because I mean, he did fight for them, you know, whatever. But if they say no, you shouldn't get mad either. I mean, you're asking for free tickets.
Don't feel entitled.
Nah, you shouldn't feel entitled that, oh, they have to give you tickets. No, but if they can give you tickets, they can. Like, why shouldn't they too, you know?
Bam, how annoyed do you get if at 6 a.m. the day of your fight, people hit you up and say, we want tickets?
Yeah, but Bam's the fighter. That's different.
That's fucked up. You shouldn't be doing that.
No, if Bam's the fighter, yeah, people shouldn't be annoying him at 6 a.m.
But they do stuff like that.
Promoters, that's different. That's their job. Like, their job is to have people come into the arena. And
why not do it 2 days before?
For the fighter, it's different. They shouldn't be annoying Bam at 6 a.m.
People ask you for tickets the day of the fight?
No.
You don't have your phone? It's off? Or?
It's on that. They know.
They know.
They know not to fucking.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of crazy shit in boxing. People don't want one ticket, they want 8 tickets. No, when it's fight week, I try not to bother the fighters, period. Just don't leave them alone. Whatever it is, it can wait after the fight. Bam, who cuts your hair? Maybe your barber. Is that, was that you asking on the live?
This is
my See? At least I'm honest and I asked. What's your name?
Rob Lowe.
Rob Lowe?
Huh?
Rob. Rob.
You look kind of hair. Right,
you guys look like influencers. Right? Like straight off Twitch or what's it called? Kick?
TikTok.
Yeah, TikTok. So are you happy about the extension? Is it what you expected, what you wanted?
Yeah.
Is the Inui fight part of the deal? What do you mean? It's a legit question.
No, it's not.
Bam is... I don't know if we got to deliver more research on it, but Bam, by the time these extensions, he's done with this extension, Bam will be the highest paid fighter to ever fight 115 pounds.
Wow, that's badass. Congratulations.
In the division. I'm not talking about like Pacquiao that fought there and went up to middleweight. I'm talking about like within 115 pounds.
So you're going to make it rain wherever you go?
He's already looking at Lamborghinis and...
No, don't be doing that.
What did you say? Yeah,
I can afford that.
He could.
No problem. But he shouldn't be doing
that. Funny, the other day I saw them. We're talking, we're like, hey, you should have the Lamborghini Urus. He's like, nah, I don't like that. And then he asked us, well, how much is it? And I was like, I think it's like $250,000, $300,000. He's like,
see?
I can do that.
Hey, buy houses, buy condos. Yeah.
Why not? If he wants to, so what? He's doing everything else smart.
The second you drive the car off the lot, it depreciates. Rent one, lease one for a year, get out of your system. No, get nice cars. I'm not saying no, get a, what's a Mercedes one? G-Wagon, like there's nice cars. You have a kid too, you have dogs. Where are you gonna put them in your Lambo?
But you know what, it's true. He's already got his girl, his baby, so he only got a Lambo. If you were young, still.
He's a family man.
Yeah. You know what, get a nice fucking little Range Rover, a nice Range Rover. That's a
nice Lexus right now.
Yeah, but you know, yeah, then don't get anything.
Just
buy your car.
What's Elon Musk's car called? The big one?
Get a motorcycle.
Yeah, Cybertruck. What are you saying, Robert?
He must get a motorcycle.
That's what Johnny Cañas just said.
Another house. Fuck it.
Or rent one for a week and get it. I'm telling you, because cars, as excited as you are to drive them, any car, you get used to it. You can have a Rolls Royce. Am I right?
If he wants to drive a.
Yeah, but you're very limited. I think you'd only do 3,000 miles total. Like we've heard of. Yeah. That's why people have those cars. I'm not going to use names, different fighters. They have them in a box truck when they drive from city to city and just drive them like a little bit.
Yeah,
A Lambo's like a girl.
You don't want to use another example.
But Bam, if you did drive a Lambo and you're taking and you're off the market, you would, in LA, you would get a lot of dates. You don't even need to speak any words. Just pull up. How come you never bought a Rolls Royce?
What?
A Rolls Royce. It's a nice car.
It's expensive, isn't
it? It looks good.
It's expensive as fuck.
You wouldn't buy one, Peter?
I can't afford one. What the fuck?
Car, that's all he needs.
I can't afford one. That's expensive.
What if you could afford one?
No.
Would you get one?
A family car, he's good.
I've never been in the cars, though. I mean, like, even like when I was younger, you know, there's kids that
Yeah.
I don't care for cars. I don't care
for Mikey loves cars.
Mikey loves cars.
I still like...
He always has. He's always been out to them.
He likes cars, he knows.
Yeah. I don't know how to change a fucking tire on my car.
He knows everything.
Well, I know how to change a tire. I do. That's the easiest
to change
a tire.
Fucking tire on a car.
Change oil is easy too. No.
I'm not a change oil. You know how to change oil?
Yeah, but not with the new cars. New cars are very. Mercedes, you have to take part half of the engine to change oil.
I remember back in the 80s and all shit like that, everybody used to do their own oil change.
Yep.
Nobody knows how to do that shit.
No, these cars are very complicated.
I don't know how to change fucking the windshield.
That's easy too. You clip it. Now, you know which car Mikey I like the most? What was the red one he had?
My favorite.
The Viper?
Was badass.
That was the
he
good.
Still has it. Oh, no, he has the white one now.
He has a white one?
Which one did I always tell Mikey was my favorite? The Range Rover, the one that he extended?
Yeah, with the two doors.
That one was my favorite. I like that. The Rolls Royce, I mean, the Range Rover that Mike has, that he extended the back window, and that car's bad. I like that one a lot. That one's my favorite car that he has.
I honestly just want a car that drives itself. I want to be productive. But it takes time. Like, you're not allowed to be in it if it drives itself or something. What does it say?
You have to be paying attention to it.
Yeah, I can't. No, I need to work, Peter. I got limited in time. So it's exciting. Bam's here. It's exciting as a day.
I have to get a bigger car already.
Three kids, huh?
I have three kids.
Yep.
I need an SUV now.
And you need a full-time nanny.
I'm going to get a... I need a big car. Who's got the hookup? Anybody on YouTube got the hookup?
For what cars?
Toyota Grand Highlander.
Doesn't Mikey have a...
Yeah,
Mikey.
You gotta
talk to Mikey. But I'm excited. Bam's fighting. You gonna be there in Philly?
Yes, I am.
November 9th, right?
I might miss the birth of my daughter for that.
You don't want to miss your birth.
Oh, no, I'm going to Bam's.
You know what he just told me? He's going to miss the birth of his daughters to be at your fight. Yeah. Are you going to give him the night off or no?
Yeah. No, I'm going to be a vampire.
Are you serious?
Oh, yes. What the fuck?
Your girl's not going to be mad that you weren't there? Not going to hold it against?
Just take her over there. Have the babies in Philly.
All I know is one kid's a lot of work, Pita. One kid's a lot of work. Three kids?
I have three kids under 2 years old.
That's a lot of work.
I don't really think it through.
You need to have one kid a little older to help with the other two kids.
I don't really think it through.
But so how's your baby doing? Good?
Good, he's getting big.
Showing personality yet? Or?
Yeah, he's starting to talk.
That's cool.
Yeah, cool. Kids are badass.
It's funny, when I first came to the gym, everybody was kids. Now everybody has kids.
Everybody has kids.
You have a kid.
Jonathan has like two kids already. Navarro?
I didn't know that.
Yeah. Chepe's got his daughter now.
Chepe.
Daughter's a little bit younger than
this. I remember him at 9 years old. He has two kids now.
Oh.
Chop chop.
Yeah. He's about to have his little boy.
Yeah.
Felipe's got like fucking...
Yeah.
Like 7, 8 kids.
Felipe's we don't know. How many baby mamas do you know?
I don't know. Charles got kids. Everybody's got kids here.